Good now. I hope you are doing well, preferably splendastic. Welcome to another episode of the Ephemeral Rift podcast. Thank you very much for tuning in. Much appreciated. I think I am going to title this particular episode Synchronicity, even though it has absolutely nothing to do with synchronicity. I don't know. Either that, or I'm going to call it Population Growth, Food, Jobs, Housing, and Environment, or I'm going to title it Let's Ban High-End Gaming PCs, but not data centers and all the global servers of the world. And we're going to get to all of those little things in just a little bit, but the reason I wanted to think about calling this synchronicity, and this is just like the last minute before I hit record here, is that I wanted to, in this episode, before we go any further, sorry, I hate to jump around like this. Next episode is going to be all about movies. So, it's been a couple weeks, I think, couple episodes since I've come to you to ask for your input. And I like to do this every so often, just, you know, for the community type of aspect and for the interaction. And I am considering doing one of these live, but just not have the audio out on the external sites because delays and the audio quality wouldn't be that good. So I might skip a week, but just do a live podcast on the channel alone. Anyway, so movies. If you could be so kind and cool to leave a comment, or you can hit me up directly via my website, ephemeralrift.com/contact, and my website is very simple, secure, and, you know, that contact goes right to my email at Gmail. And just give me a few of your favorite, or just one, some of those movies that you love, and why, okay? But if you could try to keep kind of fairly short, you know, a couple sentences, something like that, not like multiple paragraphs, just because I'm not going to be able to read all of it. And as what I usually do, I will compile all of them and we'll see what everyone likes. And hey, who knows, maybe if you're listening and or watching, you might get an idea for a movie to check out. Okay, so we'll do that. And then we will get around to anime in the future, and then another episode about music, and then who knows what else. So, okay. Anyway, and as I was about to say before the whole movie thing, so I wanted to come here in this episode and do a thing about news from around the world, like a global news report, but staying away from the typical aggravating political stuff about violence, because, you know, I wanted to just some world news. I used to do this on my podcast when it was called Ephemeral Radio, like years ago, when I would go to different webs news sites for different countries, not just CNN or BBC, try to get as local as I could. And it was kind of difficult because not all of those local online news sites are in English, right? So it's, but I tried my best, right? So, and I wanted to do that. And I wanted, one of the things I wanted to hit on in this episode was what I kind of mentioned just a couple minutes ago about banning, which I kind of find ironic given some of the natures of some of the ASMR videos I've made in my channel about banning, where they're, six states are banning high-end gaming PCs because of the energy drain and all that. And I'm going to get into a little bit of that, about that. Blah, 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 blah. And so I started to, I had all the intent and purpose of, just seeing what's going on across the world. I was going to call this episode Lifting My Head Out of the Sand, because I don't really pay attention to what's going on in the news too much, because it's pointless. Not that I don't want to be informed, but because there's a lot of aggravating news, right? There's a lot of people in politics, in positions of authority, doing things that are aggravating. There's all kinds of people doing all kinds of things that are aggravating and annoying, okay? And it hasn't changed. It's not going to change, and it's just going to continue to happen because we're animals, right? People just, we're not perfect, and we're, as much as we can put on suits and ties and dress and make ourselves look pretty or handsome, it's not going to change the fact that we're still animals, okay? And we have problems, all right? So, hey, I'm just telling it like it is. Okay, so I don't want to get into all the politics. I want to do some different types of news, just some news from across the world that has nothing to do with typical stuff that you see on the news, politics stuff. So, but I wanted to hit on the thing about the banning the gaming PCs, because that's kind of like, wow, really? You know, you're going to ban high-end gaming PCs? Like, wow, okay, that bad? Apparently, they're that bad. Okay, but we're going to get into that. But so I wanted to start this episode with a quote, and I'm going to do it here now. Because like I said, I was going to do that whole world news bit. And so I have a quote here that which leads to a person, which leads to something that the person did, which is going to lead to some of the discussion we're going to have on here on the episode, which is kind of why I'm going to call this, I think, synchronicity. And then parentheses, all the other things we're going to talk about probably. So here's the quote. The most dangerous worldviews are the worldviews of those who have never viewed the world. And that's right on. And that's a quote by Alexander von Humboldt. And I have no idea who that is. I mean, a kind of basic little idea. I kind of did a little Wikipedia thing before, you know, recording this, just to, you know, verify, right? Because whenever you see quotes and things and names associated to them, you got to kind of use a little, logical, rational, and reasonable, whatever one of those works. And just do a little research to make sure before you just parrot. You know, that's the problem. I do that sometimes too, without fully researching something, right? Because sometimes we're a little bit lazy, right? We make a lot of assumptions. We make a lot of judgment calls, instantaneous, quick. You see something going, something broken in the street, a glass. Wow, someone, right? And someone might say, oh, well, someone threw that there and dropped it there, or threw it there intentionally. Someone might say, you know, but maybe someone was getting out of their car, and for whatever reason, they were holding a glass bottle, and they accidentally dropped it and forgot to clean it up. But someone might think, wow, someone, look at that. Someone threw that glass bottle there and littered and didn't clean up after themselves, right? So we always make these snap, instantaneous little, and they're harmless in many cases, these quick, spontaneous, you know, split-second snap judgments and assumptions are harmless, okay? Right? But they can, of course, be harmful as well. But, so... This is why I'm, maybe you're the same way, you know, the brain. And then by the time 10 o'clock rolls around at night, you're exhausted. You just, because your brain, your own brain just exhausts yourself. I know it does for me. So, okay. So that quote is by Alexander. And I thought that was the perfect quote that I was going to use for this episode talking about the world news. Unfortunately, we're not going to talk about the world news. I'm going to have to say that for another episode, maybe after the next episode 21 about movies. So let's pull up Alexander von Humboldt. Check this guy out, right? White guy. You go to Wikipedia, a very pale Caucasian guy. Well, there's a painting of him. He's got the really nice kind of, I don't know what that is, suit going on with a little fruffle around the neck thing, the tie up there. And oh, wow, he's a very esteemed gentleman. He's got the classic world globe. He's in the red velvet chair, perfect painting, a portrait of him by Joseph Carl Stieler, apparently, or Stieler, is the portrait. Okay. Anyway, so what was his name again? Alexander von Humboldt, born 1769 in Berlin, Prussia, the Holy Roman Empire. He died May 6th, 1859 at age 89. Ah, that must have been nice to live that long. And when he died in the same place, Berlin, Prussia, but in 1859, it was then called the German Confederation. Okay. And so Friedrich Wilhelm Heinrich Alexander von Humboldt, that's his full name. I wish I had a, don't you wish you had a name like that? You know, instead of just Paul. I mean, that's my name, Paul. I wish I was like Friedrich Wilhelm Heinrich Alexander von Humboldt. Now that's a name. He was a German polymath or polymath. I'm not sure how you say that. I have no idea what that is. A little inkling, because like I said, I've kind of clicked on some of these things, but I just don't have it memorized. Also a geographer, a naturalist, an explorer, and a proponent of romantic philosophy and science. Blah, blah, blah. Now, here's the part that's leading me to thinking of this whole synchronicity thing. He was the first person to describe the phenomenon and cause of human-induced climate change in 1800 and again in 1831, based on observations generated during his travels. So here we are, right? I mean, that this guy looks like ahead of his time, I guess you could say. So here we are, right? Global warming, the whole thing, climate change, you know, with greenhouse gases, cars, planes, all of it, right? Factories, blah, blah, blah. And there's a lot of weird weather happening all across the world that apparently is related to global warming and our impact on the environment. And, you know, he was the first person to, you know, say, you know, discover this whole terminology or however you want to call it. And I'm going to talk about the computers and things like that, the ban and all this stuff with our population just a little bit. We're going to get to there. So that's why I'm calling this synchronicity, because, or happenstance, just, you know, I was going to, this is like, I'm not trying to make a big deal about me or what's happening, you know, but just, this is what happens in life. You just stumble onto these things. And it's like, wow, man, this is, you know, didn't expect it, unexpected, you know, and that's what I like about not planning. You know, for some reason, when you don't plan things and you just go and just stumble into things, a job, a relationship, things just seem to work out. Not always. There are some things you stumble into, some jobs and some relationships that don't work out. But it's all not doom. It's not all doom and gloom and negative, okay? But this is one of those funny little examples of happenstance or synchronicity, however you want to call it, where I was going to do the worldview report, and I started to look in. Let's talk about this whole thing with banning the gaming PCs. And I was going to start up with this quote, and here's this guy, and he's talking about human-induced climate change and how here we are, you know, talking about climate change and related to the banning the PCs and all this stuff I'm going to get into. And it's like, wow, okay, so maybe I was meant to talk about all this, I guess. The universe didn't want me, the forces at work didn't want me to talk about world news, but instead they wanted me to talk about, what was his name again? Friedrich Wilhelm Heinrich Alexander von Humboldt, the man with four first names, apparently. So imagine introducing yourself to this guy, right? All right, that'll be me. Hello, my name is Paul, and you are?
Friedrich Wilhelm Heinrich Alexander von Humboldt, the man with four first names.
I'm just trying to throw in, I don't know what kind of accent the guy had. But that's what, we need to bring back four first names. I think that's what we need. I want to be Paul, Wilhelm, Joe, Stephen. That's it. I don't think we should go back to that. Just start giving our children 4, 5, 10 first names. And then just imagine the roll call during school. Okay. I bet you the teachers, when they're trying to go around the roll, you know, through the schools, through the class with this guy, right? Okay. Joe, here. Okay. Henry, here. Friedrich Wilhelm Heinrich Alexander. Friedrich Wilhelm Heinrich Alexander. Oh, I guess Friedrich Wilhelm Heinrich Alexander isn't here today. So I don't know. Which one do you pick to call him? You call him Wilhelm, Willie, Henry, Heinrich, Alex, Fred, Will, Henry, Alex. You know. So all right, it's just the four first names. It's funny. It's funny to me. That's all that matters. And maybe it's funny to you too. Okay. Anyway, so. All right, so we're done with this guy. Get out of here. You're dead. You're old news to me now. You're fun. You were You were worth the whatever little bit of entertainment. Let me go to my document I have pulled up here. Where is my little document using Office Libre, Libre? I used to use OpenOffice, but then someone said, hey, you check out, Office. OpenOffice apparently is more, I don't know, corporate or something. I don't know, something's changed about them in terms of their structure. But if you want to support a really more open source, more free, whatever, less of a company oriented thing, then use LibreOffice apparently. So I'm using LibreOffice now. All right. So, okay. So we are going to talk about the whole banning the PC thing, the stuff about the global warming, the energy consumption, and I'm not here to doom and gloom, right? I know a lot of folks, they go watch my videos on my channel to get away, to relax, and all that, right? So I'm not here to trigger anyone or bring some be negative. I mean, I could easily come here and just rant and destroy the people. Make it personal, attack people, go after just, that whole negative thing. It's not really a negative, it's just that whole cynical thing is a better word. But I still want to talk about these things, but we're trying to do it in a lighthearted way. So it's not too heavy, and depressing. Okay. So bear with me. Okay, I think I got it all figured out. So before we get into this whole thing about the banning the PCs and then all this, I think we need to talk about us human beings and how we continue to grow. Okay, and I think, I'm not sure, maybe there's a paradox. We did a couple episodes ago, a few episodes, 3, 4, 5, something, about paradoxes. And maybe there's a paradox about this. I don't really have, it's not really too important, regarding our existence. And that paradox is, if it doesn't exist, well, maybe now it does, is the continued growth of our species combined with the knowledge of said growth and how we cause a strain on the Earth's resources. So there is the conundrum, the paradox, that we're humans, right? We're here, we're alive, we continue to grow, yet we put a strain on resources, right? And we know this, but what can we do? We can't do anything. You can't just say, oh, okay, let's just get rid of half the population. No, right? No one's going to sacrifice them. Okay, I'm going to jump in the volcano and for the greater good of less draining resources of the environment, right? No one's going to, I'm not going to like take, 5 million people and just, send them out into the volcano, into the whatever. So that's the paradox to me, for me, and you just, this whole thing now of how many there are of us, there's almost about 8 billion. Sorry. It's like 7.8 billion at this point, but might as well just throw in a couple hundred thousand for shits and giggles and just call it 8 billion. Fuck it. Everybody likes estimates, round numbers, right? 8 billion. So as we continue to grow, our human population growth is going to require continued and large amounts of food to feed currently approximately 8 billion people. And the estimate by 2057, which is 35 years, something like that from now, 10 billion people. So 2 billion more people will be here on the planet. In like less than, half a century. That's the estimate. Now, some sources say that our growth is slowing down a tiny percentage, like from the 1900s. Apparently, there was a big boom in the 1900s, I guess because of the industrialization and all that, and people were just popping out, whatever the best popping sound makes, kids left and right. So there's huge population growth. Now, there's one source I looked at that said it looks like the population growth is slowing down by like a percentage, right? So, I don't know. 1% of 8 billion is what? 8,000 or something like that? It's not really significant. Another source says that there's rapid growth, especially in urban areas. So, it doesn't really matter. too much. Slow, really fast. There's 8 billion now. There's going to be more. There's not all of a sudden, it's just not going to be, it's going to remain at 8 billion and it's not going to go down to like 2 billion in 5 years. Okay. Now, listen, I'm not want to alarm. Okay. Remember, I'm trying to talk about this as objectively, as lighthearted as possible. This is not doom and gloom. I'm not an alarmist. This is not paranoia talk. Okay. Trying to be realistic here. Okay. There's 8 billion people and feeding all those people, right? You just can't. You know, if you don't feed people from a garden, you know, there's a lot of people, especially in dense urban areas and cities. That's where most of the people are. Okay. So right now it's 8 billion. And apparently in 30 years, there's going to be 10 billion. And then what? 12, 20 billion. So you see what I'm saying? What I'm trying to say is that it doesn't matter whether our growth is slow or is fast, whatever, we're not going to go away. There's 8 billion now. It's not going to drop down, like I said, to 4 million, you know, or 200,000. It's just going to keep, we're going to keep growing. You're not going to, how do you stop? You can't force people to not reproduce, okay? So the only thing you can do, we're banning, the whole banning thing. I feel like the whole, I'm not sure if you're familiar with what I do on YouTube. I do a lot of role play fictional scenarios to help relax people. And one of those scenarios is I've created a fictional new world order that has banned everything in existence, even some absurd, I love absurdity and playing around with absurd notions of banning nothing, like nothing, okay? You know, banning sugar and all this. It's funny, I haven't banned high-end gaming computers in a video yet, but now I might actually have to because of it's made the news and it's actually a thing happening. But so what are you going to do? They're going to ban reproduction? I mean, right? Isn't there some law in China? I'm pretty sure China or Japan. And one of those countries, didn't they put a rule where you can only have one child per household, something like that? I'm not sure if that was like fake news. I'm pretty sure that's real news. It's kind of old. It's like 10 years old now or something like that. When I first heard about that, I haven't really researched it or anything. But so what are you going to do? You can't stop people from reproducing. Okay. So we're going to continue to grow. What are you going to do? So, all right. So we're going to continue to require large amounts of food to feed everybody. The next thing is we're going to need jobs. These people are going to need to do something with their lives. We no longer live like our ancestors do. We're no longer self-reliant. We're not autonomous. No, we're not independent. We don't know how to do shit for ourselves. But most of us, all right? We don't know how to fend for ourselves. You put 7 billion, 7.5 billion, all these people into the woods. You think they're going to know what to do? No, they're probably going to be on their phones complaining that they're in the woods. You know, oh my God, I can't believe I'm out here. I got to hunt. This sucks. It's horrible. There's bugs out here. It's hot. Oh my God. Was that a snake? Ew, gross. Right? So I wouldn't know what to do out in the woods. You put me out there. I ain't going to live very long. Maybe that's the answer, right? So we're going to need jobs. So 10 billion people by 2057, and they're going to need more jobs. And where are these jobs going to be, right? I mean, how you just make jobs? So that's going to be the never-ending more people. You're going to need more food. Now we need more jobs. All those kids going to grow up. You know, where are these jobs going to come from? The next thing is housing demand. And this is kind of my final little point I want to make, I guess, in regards to our population growth and all this stuff with global warming and energy consumption is, well, 2 more billion people are on the way in the next 30, 50 years. Where are you going to house them all? And it doesn't stop there, right? So that's 2057 is the estimate for 10 billion people. Well, what about the year 2100? What's that? 15 billion? And what about 100 years from then? 20 billion, right? 30 billion. We're not going to slow down. So the housing, Where's all the housing? Where are they going to live? Well, we have to destroy more forests, more wooded areas, right? So then we're just going to keep expanding from the cities to the suburbs, and the suburbs will continue to, you know, grow, and eventually people become, the suburbs will then become almost somewhat city-like, you know, dense, and then people from the suburbs will move out to the rural areas, and that's what happens. Can you continue to expand? Continue to, all the trees that people are planting, you know, it's almost pointless because they're all going to get torn down anyway to build new buildings, offices, skyscrapers, and housing for the billions of people that are coming. All right, we're going to need more jobs. So you're going to need to build structures for more offices, okay, and all this. Now, that's, I'm trying to be as rational as possible. I'm not trying to be an alarmist here. I'm not trying to be like, oh, doom and gloom. Oh, no, this is so terrible. No, it's just, that's just a fact. That's what's going to happen. I mean, that's what's happened over, here we are. That's what's happened now. You know, where a lot of people live in the suburbs and the rural areas used to be just trees. And now they're all gone. And there's going to be trees that are planted somewhere, but they're going to be torn down and knocked down. And there's farms, right? So eventually, we're going to run out of space somewhere because you have the farmlands, right? So we can't really encroach on there, and we're going to end up meeting all the people in the cities. The cities become more dense. People moving out in the suburbs. Suburbs coming more dense. People moving out into the rural, and then you're going to be butting up against all the people in the farmlands. No, so I don't know what's going to happen. So, and, you know, I just, more people, more housing, more structures, more buildings, more offices, more jobs, and more stress on the environment. So I don't have an answer. You know, more places to live. These people are going to need, you know, more single homes are going to be put up, more apartment complexes, more condominiums, more housing developments, whatever, right? And more office buildings for people to work at. So I don't know what the answer is. I'm not really, you know, I don't have all the answers. That's not what it's really about. You know, I'm good at, you put me into any environment, and maybe you are the same way. You go into a place, especially if you're kind of an analytical type of person, you know, you're very observant. You like to, you analyze, sometimes you overthink things. So you can put us into an environment and we can look around and we can find the cracks. What's wrong with that? Blah, blah, blah. And we might not know how to fix it, but we are good at pointing out the problems. Okay. And a lot of people think we're negative, and it's really hard. You can easily fall into that negative kind of thing when you're constantly pointing out problems. And some of that might come from a place of whatever, from a person's life experience, okay? But I am critical. I can admit it. I am cynical, but I'm not a person where that's a small percentage. 10%, 20%, okay? If you're around me, there is more fun. While, yes, I am going to be critical and I am going to be cynical, all right? And I'm going to question things. Why are you doing that? Blah, blah, blah. But it's not all the time. And it's the conversation I have with my wife. You know, there is a lot of happiness and there is a lot of fun, goofiness, and all that, okay? Just like you hear here in the podcast. But there's going to be times when I'm just going to tell it like it is. All right. And that's the kind of people that almost sounds like I'm trying to promote myself. I'm going to say that's the kind of people that we need. That kind of sounds a little bit self-serving or whatever, but that's the kind of people I've always liked. People that just fucking tell it like it is, even though it's going to hurt, because you need that sometimes. Sometimes you don't know what you're doing is offending someone or hurting someone or is wrong. And there might be someone, you know, you gotta be just like, you gotta like, you know, not punch a person, but I'm just trying to use that, you know, in case you're just listening to this, I'm, you know, punching my fist into my palm of my hand. That you just need that wake up call. And I know I've been that way all throughout my life, even as a kid. I mean, one time there was a friend of mine come to my house, was always late. I'm waiting for him to pick me up because I didn't drive and he drove. I'm not sure why I never learned to drive, whatever, at that point in time. I don't know. My dad had a car, whatever. I don't know. Weird. Okay. Anyway. And so I'll be waiting for him to come pick me up and always kept me waiting. And one thing I fucking hate in the world is being kept waiting. Maybe you're the same way. Cause I'm always on time. Let it go. Let's go. All right. Here I am. Let's get started. All right. You want me somewhere on time? I'm there on time. Okay. Unless it's a place I don't want to be. I mean, that's how I used to be when I was younger or whatever, you know, except, you know, work, you got to be at work on time. Okay. There's been times I used to show up, whatever, but I got out of that. There's things you got to work through. You're going through whatever you hate, blah, blah, blah. You hate doing things. It's laziness. It's you fucking hate the job, whatever, but you got to fucking do it. And you work through all that emotional shit so you can get into a point in your life where you can just laugh about it and go to a place and do the thing and blah. So anyway. And I just don't keep me waiting. That's all. I'm not talking about you listening or whatever in terms of, you know, sending me comments or things for my podcast. I'm just talking about, I'm not really like this anymore too much, a little bit, certain times. You know, if we're going to say we're going to do a thing at a time, just fucking be there at the fucking time. You know, that's it. Just, you know, don't be like 10 minutes later or five, or every fucking time. We're going to meet at a time and you're always the fucking guy. I'm losing my shit right now, right? But this is not like, I'm just saying, you know, there are, I know you probably feel like, wow, man, this is coming from a place, you know, some pent up anger issues from when I, no, it's not. It wasn't all the time, my friend. There is just some people that consistently, and this isn't about anyone in particular, but I'm just saying, I'm just exaggerating. If you're going to say, hey, you know, we're going to meet, you know, pick me up, blah, 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 do whatever, you know, be consistent. If you're going to be late one time, that's fine. It's fine. It's okay. But if you're consistently late, you know, especially when it comes to whatever it is, you know, then that's a problem. Okay. So it's a long story short, too late. So this friend, my high school friend, we were really good friends too. And, you know, this was like, I don't know how many times it was that he kept me waiting. You know, he would come, you know, hey, I'm going to come pick you up at 8 o'clock. I'm like, oh, great. And I'm sitting there, I'm just waiting, you know, like a little puppy. No, where's my master coming to take me out for a walk? Right. So I'm waiting for my friend to come with his car, you know, at 8 o'clock or whatever. It's like 10 after, 5 after. Right. And I'm fucking, I think you might have, if you've been following me, listen to me on this podcast, you know, patience and anger, they're like husband and wife in my headspace. You know, patience and anger. I'm not sure which came first, okay? But whatever it is, my patience, when it comes to, I don't know, certain things, and it's been like this all throughout my life, and it's been a work, it's been a struggle to become more patient and less angry, I don't want to get into the whole thing about me, but anyway, I'm sure you can relate, right? Patience, short temper, some of us have that for whatever reason, some people don't. There's some people do not have this, whatever I got going on, a lot of people have, and a lot of people don't. A lot of people are just fucking are cool and calm, and they have like no anger, and I don't know. They're just, you know, they're just happy. They're not simple or stupid. They're smart people, but they don't have the patience thing and the anger. They're like whatever. And I wish I had that. I wish I had that just kind of thing where so my patience doesn't get the best of me and then I fucking flip out, which I don't really flip out that much anymore. So the one point, again, getting back to, I got to finish this fucking story. Holy shit. Sorry. I'm trying to make a good point here. I promise. So when he finally shows up, it was like the fourth, fifth time he was late picking me up. And we drive somewhere going somewhere and we stop, we park, whatever, to do whatever we're getting ready to do. And I finally confronted him. I was like, dude, can you just like, fuck, you know, for once, you're always showing up late. Can you once pick me up on time or whatever? And he's like, oh, he's like, dude, sorry, I just didn't know that mean, you know, that much to you or whatever. And he wasn't being sarcastic, right? And I wasn't really being an asshole to him. I was just kind of like, I was just stewing. I was holding it in. He picked me up. I was like, hey, what's up? Whatever, whatever. We drove to whatever. And I'm like sitting here stewing, like, do I say what I got, you know? And I finally like, fuck it, I'm going to say it. And just, and I exploded. But I didn't freak out and fucking attack the guy and get into a fight. I was just like, dude, can you like, you know, I'm tired of you waiting all the time, whatever. And I just told him straight up without being a dick about it. And he was like, oh, I didn't know. And that's 10 minutes ago is what the point I was trying to make now, 10 minutes later, is that some people just need that, you know, that, hey, bah, that verbal blah, blah, blah attack, which they'll, oh my God, he's so mean to me. But no, I'm not trying to fucking be mean. I'm just trying to make you understand that whatever you're doing is not cool. It more not respective of, you know, you're not listening to me. You know, you're not seeing me as important or something like that. You know what I mean? It's disrespectful in a way. So I, you know, it wasn't a big deal, but my whole point is sometimes there are people that just do things and they just don't know that what they're doing, I don't want to say offend you, but bothers you or impacts you or something. And you have to you just got to fucking say that thing and you got to let them know. And that's, you know, that's how it is. And some people they'll be cool with it. And I'm cool with that. Sometimes if I'm open and receptive, you know, I'm very hard on myself as it is. So I know I have a lot, you know, I don't really need anyone else to tell me that I got to, you know, work on this. I fucking know I do. I know I got my fucking short temper and anger issues that I've been working on all my life. But look, I gave up smoking. I gave up drinking. All right. Alcohol. I know I've had a couple drinks earlier this year. I had the one beer, my first beer in like 3 or 4 years. And before that, I had like one or two months before that, I had one or two, the little, you know, wine cooler drinks. But I'm done. I don't really need alcohol in my life. I don't think it's good for us. And, you know, so I've done that. Now, sugar, you know, fast food, you know, I do limit the fast food, you know, but sugar, I don't think I'm going to ever, you know, stop eating chocolate until it gets to the point where the doctor says, okay, now I have type 2 onset diabetes, which is pretty much imminent. You know, my parents, I'm not sure if both of them have it or one of them does. And so that's just the diabetes things. I did some research, and one of the reasons why I know there's some folks that have diabetes early in their life, whatever, but one of the reasons why you get diabetes when you get older, from what I understand, it's because through evolution, because it comes on so late, I forget how it went, but something about where evolution hasn't gotten rid of us getting diabetes because of just how something about it coming on later in life. This was like about a year ago. I was looking into it. Now I know that the constant that's as far as diabetes itself existing. I know that we can bring diabetes on or cause it to happen by eating, you know, sugar and all that and blah blah blah. Anyway, so okay, so but you know, sometimes, you know, that's what people need, and maybe you've done that, maybe you've had it happen to you. I just think it, you know, just being honest, being straightforward. Sometimes you just can't be nice and not say things, you know, and especially when it comes, you know, forget about just that you need, that you're feeling disrespected. You know, sometimes you need to say something just because maybe you don't feel that people are listening to you or hearing you or whatever it is. And you just need to, you know, especially if you're listening to this and you've been struggling with something, you just got to say it. You just got to say it. What do you have to lose? I mean, I've been at jobs and I've said shit. I've walked off jobs, you know? There's just more, I can't, I don't think you can put any more higher value on anything in life than just being that straightforward, honest, gonna fucking tell you like it is. And if you don't like it, take it or leave it. Don't really care. I'm not gonna change. You know? So no, but you know, there's a time and place, right? But if, I mean, you know, I've confronted my parents about, I'm getting onto a whole thing here I wasn't really meant to talk about, but I had a thing with my parents, you know, a blowout over something back when I was 17 or 18 or whatever. You know, I had an event, you know, you just sometimes, you know, you try to be nice, you keep it in, right? And it just builds up, and that's just not healthy, and you got to let it all out. And that's why I don't really watch much of the news or anything, is because all that, what comes in, you know, must go out, pretty much, right? So everything you take in, right, the news, whatever, all that stuff, just the constant, you know, murders today, deaths, corrupt politicians, the weather, the fucking, all the worst shit in the world, right, the news is, and it can just make you just aggravated. So now you take all this stuff in, and just, you know, you take it in, and, you know, it's got to come out, right? If you just hold on to it, it's going to make you nuts. So that's why I turn off, that's why, like I said, one of the very first episodes of this podcast, why I left social media, because I liked using social media. I didn't ever want to not leave it, because I liked interacting, you know, being in touch as much as possible with the folks that would watch my videos or whatever. But after a while, I was like, well, one of the reasons I left, because it's kind of like, you know, narcissistic, social, look at me kind of bullshit. But the other thing is, like, I would go on Twitter, and I mentioned this before, you know, maybe this will be the last time I ever talk about it. And I would see like a tweet come in, or, you know, randomly from someone else saying something. And I was like, man, I don't really care. You know, I didn't want to see that. I don't really, I'm here to just use Twitter just to kind of say whatever shit to whoever, you know, I don't want to have to see some stupid political thing or some bullshit philanthropy nonsense games, follow me and win something, all that shit. I'm going to talk about that in the podcast in another month or so. All that stuff, all those games that wealthy people play. But that shit would aggravate me. And then, you know, social media is just, hey, if you use it, hey, that's fine. You know, that I'm not saying, you know, that's the thing. Just because I don't like something doesn't mean it should go away. That's not how the world works. There's a lot of people who think that because, oh, I don't like this, so you shouldn't, that, blah, 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 blah. Like, no, that's not how the world works. Everyone is free to do whatever they want. Human beings are absolutely free to do whatever they want, legal, illegal. I'm not condoning that. I'm not saying they should do illegal things. I don't want to get in trouble here. But people do every day. You see it. They do things that are called illegal, but that's just human nature, people being people. You can't stop animals. You can take the animal out of the jungle, but you can't take the jungle out of the animal. And that's what we are. We're part of the animal kingdom. We know, just because we wear suits and ties and drive around in cars and sing and dance and do all kind of video game stuff and lectures and blah and sound important and look handsome and pretty doesn't mean like we're some new fucking highly evolved perfect species on the planet. We're not. Take a look around. There's poverty. Poverty is a glaring, if anything, it's like a blemish on humanity. The fact that there's poverty and poor people and people struggling and just garbage, just this cancer. I'm not saying that people in those poor people are cancerous. I'm just saying the fact that there is poverty and you know, just there is just such a disparity is a blemish on this society that tries to portray itself as so professional and look at my investments and my fancy car. Yeah, poverty. Okay, so every time someone, it's like, yo, yeah, my awards. Hey, I won this new award. Yeah, poverty. Oh, look at us, folks. We've invented this. Oh, yeah, poverty. So every time someone tries to make themselves, you know, oh, I won this. I'm a 5-time Olympic gold medalist. Poverty. So, blah, 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 poverty. Hey, but what about poverty? Yeah, but look at my poverty. 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 That should be their constant response every time. Hey, look at me. I put together this poverty. That's it. You know, So until, you know, poverty and people living in just and exploitation goes away, right? And just, you know, disparity goes away, I'm not impressed. Color me impressed when the world is as pristine and perfect as everyone is pretending it to be, okay? And then I will personally congratulate you, okay? Congratulations. You got rid of poverty. You solved the world of hunger. Good for you, people. Good for you. Okay? So, yeah. Yeah. So, all right. Anyway, man, I feel like I don't know. There's a lot of shit going on that I'm getting out, but I didn't really plan on any of this. This is just how it goes. We're just on that. We are together in this boat going down the fucking stream, down the road of just, you know, unfiltered consciousness, taking it where it goes. And is it a train wreck? Maybe. Who knows? No, the train's on fire. You know, it's going off the rails. We've crashed. And hey, I'm fine with that. I'm cool with the train wreck. Okay. So, all right. So we talked about all the population stuff. Let's get back on track. We got to get into the banning the high-end gaming stuff. So let's talk about that. And we're going to move into some of the world population stuff, some stats about that as well. It's all this stuff is interrelated. So the whole high-end gaming PC, 6 states have banned high-end gaming computers due to California's 2017 energy bill that recently went into effect. And we can read, actually, I clicked on a thing to bring it up, but I actually copied it and pasted it into a document. 2/3 of Americans, which is 220 million out of about 330 million, play computer games. Although among the most complex and energy-intensive plug loads, gaming has been largely overlooked in energy research and development and policy. Systems used for computer gaming in California consumed 4.1 terawatt hours a year in 2016, or 700 million in energy bills, with emissions of 1.5 million tons carbon dioxide equivalent allocated 66% to consoles, 31% to desktop personal computers, 3% to laptops, and less than 1% to emerging media streaming devices. And if you want to read more about this, you can just it's a big long link here. It's energy.ca.gov/publications/2019/plug-loads-game-changer-computer-gaming-energy-efficiency-without-performance. So that's the title of the entry. It's like navigating, a dictionary or an encyclopedia, trying to type in that link. Okay, so all right. That sounds really bad, right? But I got some information for you that I think it's going to make that little energy usage amount seem very minuscule. Okay, you ready for this? Okay. So, I was like, wow. So I'm thinking to myself, wow, how bad are high-end gaming computers? How bad is this? What is this 4.1 terawatt hours in 2016 based on, you know, gaming computers or gaming that's going on, right? Console, PC, blah, blah, blah. 4.1 terawatt hours. So I'm thinking to myself, okay, well, wait a minute. What about all the servers in the world and all the data centers, right? Right? So I did a Google, and I'm trying to do some investigative research here, okay, to try to understand this whole banning high-end gaming computers. How bad is the energy consumption to compared to, I don't know, all the cars in the world or all the planes traveling back and forth in the atmosphere and all the jet fuel, all the fuel that they use, or all the lights that are constantly on in every city, every office building for the most part, right? All the street lights all across the world. You take a look at a nighttime picture, the whole world's lit up. Okay. So we don't talk about that. So there's that. All right. So, all right. So I'm trying to think, all right. So how bad, but let's talk about computers. How bad is this 4.1 terawatt hours, high-end gaming computers, enough to ban gaming computers? So what about all these servers, right? There's a ton of servers across the world that run So let me tell you this. There are about 100 to 200 million computer servers in the world. Now, it was about, I tried to figure out that, you know, these numbers, these 100 million. A few years ago, it was about 100 million. And then I saw a little snippet somewhere on one of my Google entries that said, well, as of 2019 or 2020, there might be 200 million servers. So it might be 200 million, but I'm saying 100 to 200 just to, you know, cover my bases. Okay, so, and most of them are owned by Google and Microsoft, okay? So here we are, we're trying to ban, you know, high-end gaming computers, 4.1 terawatt hours. But let's talk about the Google and Microsoft servers, the hundreds of millions of servers that they own all across the world, for all the Google Drive, for all the emails, for all their own company, you know, corporate, for YouTube, all the, how about YouTube? Think about this. How much power does Google use? How many servers to power YouTube, right? So here we go. Based on numbers from 2018, apparently data centers consumed 200 terawatts in 2018, compared to the 4.1 terawatts in 2016 of high-end gaming computers. And you can do this research yourself. I'm not making this shit up. All right, I did a little Google. You know, I did my best to try to prepare for this podcast. I'm not here to, no, this isn't some kind of investigative reporting journalist news site or web. I got to make completely accurate and spend hours and hours trying to research one little thing. Okay. But no, you know, I don't know. Has anybody else made this comparison yet? I don't know. I didn't really look to find out. But that's what I'm. So we're gonna ban the high-end gaming computers because they contribute to 4.1 terawatt hours. But all the data centers in the world, all the servers in the world in 2018 consumed 200 terawatt hours. Let me repeat, 4.1 terawatt hours. Ban high-end gaming computers. 200 terawatt hours. Data centers and servers across the world. No restrictions, no bans. So I want to know how much energy YouTube videos take up. Let's think about all the servers, right? And Google. So what are you going to do? We're going to ban servers now? Well, I mean, that fair is fair, right? If we're going to ban high-end gaming computers for just 4.1 terawatt hours in 2016, what about all the fucking servers across the world that are consuming 200 terawatt hours? That is 50 times more. 50 times more than the high-end gaming computer threat to the energy usage. You see, this is the fucking shit with the world that just aggravates me. You know, the stupidity of it. I'm not saying that we shouldn't ban gaming. I don't really give a fuck what you do. What people are going to do, what they're going to do, whatever. But you're gonna start doing this little, you know, okay, well, let's ban high-end game. Well, what about the servers all across the world? 200 terawatt usage, 200 all across the world, data centers and servers combined. All right. Oh, I think it's all, is that all across the world? Is that just 9 states? 200 terawatt. So we're doing 4.1 terawatt hours in the United States. Okay. So wait, you know what? I might be wrong here. I might be freaking out a little bit. Maybe my freak out is a little whatever. It's a pre. I can't think of the word. A little assuming here. Okay. So wait. I'm thinking maybe that 100. Maybe that 200 terawatts is all across the world, compared to the 4.1 terawatts of high-end gaming computers in the United States. So what is the high-end gaming computer uses all across the world? Is that 200? So. All right, now I need to think, you know what I should have done? I should have, now I'm starting to feel like a little bit like an idiot because I'm trying to compare global data centers to United States high-end, United States computer usage high-end. So that's kind of bad comparison to make. Okay, so what's the power consumption usage in the United States? All right, let me see if I can do a quick Google here of... Let me go to google.com And I'm going to type in here, United Total Servers United States. Let's see what results I get. How many data servers are in the United States? The stats show the number of data centers in the United States by location and type in 2018. There are 418 data center service providers in the United States. There are, while most of the 504 hyperscale facilities are in the U.S., the highest rates of growth have been in Europe and Asia Pacific, China, Japan, the U.K., Germany, and Australia. Okay. So, United States Data Energy Usage Report. Here we go. I found exactly the thing I'm looking for to back this up. This is by osti.gov, 2016. United States Data Center Energy Report. Wow, this is a really long report. Look at this. You can go right here to osti.gov/servlets/, what is that, Perl? I don't know. Anyway, if you just listen to Google, but there's a whole report here. It's a multiple page, a lot of many pages here. We have I got to read this off to you. I feel like we have storage energy use, network energy use, hyperscale shift scenario, energy efficiency trends beyond 2020, server utilization and power proportionality, workload variation. Total server installed base by data center space category. Holy crap. Wow. Okay. So I'm trying to figure out here. Let's see if I can find. Okay. So one of the very first graphs I'm looking at is figure ES1, projected data center total electricity use. Estimates include energy used for servers, storage, network equipment, and infrastructure in all U.S. data centers. The solid line represents historical estimates from 2000 to 2014, and the dashed lines represent five projection scenarios through 2020. Okay. All right. So basically, there's a black line and starts at around 2000. Okay. Just in case you're listening, and of course, if you're on YouTube watching, I don't have the scale, I don't have the thing, the graphic pulled up. So we have annual electricity use, billion kilowatt hours. That's what it says. And I just realized that the terawatt hours is trillion. So this is gigawatts, which is billion. So as of 2020, we have reached about 60 billion or 60 gigawatt hours as far as data center usage in the United States total. And the best practices, if all these whatever best practices get implemented, that can be reduced back down to around the 2000 levels, where it was at 20 or a billion kilowatt hours or 20 gigawatts. So I was a little bit wrong and presumptive. That's the word, presumptive. Presumptuous, I was thinking, but presumptive. So I guess it was presumptive of me to make the comparison of four terawatt. And what was that number again for PC gaming PCs? They're all upset about 4.1 terawatt hours, which is 4 trillion terawatt hours in 2016 compared to the 60 billion or 60 giga watt hours of the U.S. data centers. But this report is also, when is this report from? This report is from 2016. So this is a four or five year old report. So, okay. So maybe I misspoke a little bit. So maybe the data centers, globally, they consume 200 terawatt hours, which is far more than the U.S. 4 terawatt hours. So that still remains the same. The global data centers across the world combined, I think. I don't think this is the U.S. I forget where my source is from, but whatever. So, all right. So maybe my whole thing about, hey, you know, we're banning high end gaming computers because of the 4 trillion hours of 4 trillion watts that they're using in 2016, combined to the lesser 60 billion, I guess, watts of the data centers in the U.S. So, but I don't know. I'm kind of skeptical of that. Like, are there more, you know, consoles and gaming computers, are they using more energy than all the data centers in the United States? I mean, think about YouTube, think about Netflix, think about all the companies and all their servers, right? And all that. So, however, so maybe the data centers are on par, maybe a little bit less, okay? But my point still remains the same. Hey, I might be a little bit wrong with my numbers, but my point is, my argument is still valid. The data centers, all this technology, data centers, computers, right, it's still using up a lot of power, even the data centers. So we're going to go after a high-end gaming computers, right? But again, my argument still remains the same. What about the data centers? What about all the YouTube videos? How much terawatt hours, right, does YouTube take up? Think about that. And Netflix and the television. Can you imagine? So we're going to ban high-end gaming computers, right? That's kind of safe in a way, right? There's also crypto mining. I'm sure there's crypto mining involved in there. But can you imagine if we come to find out that the terawatt hours of TV consumption, what's that? And then we're going to ban TVs. So this is where it all starts. We're banning high-end gaming computers, right? More people. So this is where my whole thing with population growth. 8 billion people right now. We're using up all this power right now, whatever it is, right? All this electricity is putting a strain on whatever resources and carbons and all that stuff, right? Well, guess what? 30 years from now, projected 10 billion people. Whether it's 30 years or 50, it doesn't matter. There's still going to be more billions of people here than there are here today, okay? We're not going to stop growing. The human race is not all of a sudden be like, oh, you know what? Let's be responsible. Let's stop reproducing, everybody, and just remain at our current rate of population so that we can address all of the problems that we have in the world. Let's ban the high-end gaming computers. Let's ban the data centers. Let's ban TVs. Let's ban cars. Let's ban tobacco and cigarettes because we know those are very bad and they cause cancer. Let's ban alcohol because of drunk driving and all the anger and rage and just the alcoholism and the disease attributed to that. And let's go on and let's just ban planes because of all the fuel consumption and all this shit that they're putting up, polluting in the atmosphere, right? So where does it end? So we're going to start banning high-end gaming computers. Oh, you can't stop there. Y'all know. The horse is out of the gate, right? You gotta keep going. Right, you're trying to make a statement here that is no, too much power consumption, high-end gaming computers, tisk, tisk, tisk. We're gonna ban you. See ya. All right, well, you can't stop there, can you? Oh no, you're setting the bar now, or whatever the fucking right phrase is. Well, now we gotta go to data centers. But seriously, if we're trying to do this thing with the environment and stuff. Well, why haven't we banned, you know, tobacco? Can you just imagine banning? Let's just hold on. So I got this other thing I got to touch on. We're banning high-end gaming computers, right? That is where's the numbers? Where's that whole little clip? That whole little section that I grabbed from the official article. Okay, here we go. Oh, I'm sorry. The 4.1 terawatt hours a year was computer gaming in California. Okay, holy shit. Systems used for computer gaming in California consumed 4.1 terawatt hours. So I was losing my shit thinking that it was all across the United States. So that's 4.1 terawatt hours in California alone. Okay. All right. So, I made the mistake. There we go. I made another bad mistake there when I assumed that it was 4.1 for the United States. Okay. So maybe I'm a little bit more wrong in my argument in terms of the amount of gaming in the United States. You know, if it's just 4.1 terawatt hours in California, what's the total terawatt hours of gaming in the United States? All right, so I'll need to research that and then, you know, go back to the whole server thing across the United States. But still, energy consumption, you know, we're still using a lot of energy. Maybe my argument against the servers and everything and the YouTube servers and Google, Microsoft is, you know, a little weak. All right. So, however, all right, we're still using energy. But here's the thing that the final point I want to make. Can you imagine if we ban, so we're trying to ban, you know, we're trying to be conscious. We're all trying to be health conscious, energy conscious, right? But one thing you never, there's so many weak, cowardly people in the world. I really can't stand because no one wants to take the hard line. No one wants to stand up and speak out against cigarettes or drinking alcohol, right? Hard drugs, right? I mean, name all the comedians, entertainers. I don't care who you are, you know, right? All the great people. I don't care, you know, black, white, whatever. How often do you see anybody taking that hard line and saying, stop smoking. It's bad for you. Let's stop drinking alcohol causes, you know, let's stop gambling. No, what do we see all the time? We still continue to see, you know, everyone wants to play it safe is what I'm getting at. No one wants to speak out, right? No one wants to open. We don't want to upset anybody. Why don't want to upset anybody? Because they're going to lose money. They're going to lose their fans. They're going to lose their constituency, whatever. No one wants to really say, maybe we should stop selling alcohol. Alcohol, I'm sorry. I'm speaking from the truth. I was on the inside. I went to Catholic school, and that's bad for you. I drank alcohol. That's bad for you. I smoked cigarettes. That's bad for you. There's plenty of people that have the, you know, the throat cancer or whatever types of cancer from drinking tobacco, all kinds of alcoholism related problems. But let's not ban alcohol. Oh, no. Holy shit. Can you imagine the fucking outrage from all the people? Oh my God, are you going to ban my cigarettes and you're going to ban my alcohol? You know what I'm talking about? I'm not trying to say if you drink alcohol or you're an idiot or you smoke, but you know, it's true. All right. If you were to, I would have no fucking problem with that. I have no problem if you ban computers, if you, you know, banned a podcast, if you ban YouTube, I'll find another fucking thing to do to try to earn a living. I have no problem with that. Or resorting, if I can't find a fucking job, something happens to me, then I'll resort to the government paying me some kind of assistance to live. right? Because that's, you know, that's what you have to do sometimes if you get into a real bad situation and you can't actually work and you're disabled or whatever, you need some assistance. That's only fair, you know? But the millionaires don't want to, I'm going to rant about the millionaires now? No, let's not do that. But let's not ban, you know what I'm saying? Right, all these people, all these politicians, all these celebrities, oh, they want it real easy. They do all the safe, easy reporting or all the safe policies, right? But let's not, you know, or even the companies themselves, like the sports companies, the NFL and all that, right? Do you think they're going to say, no, we don't want to have any alcohol associated with our teams or no, right? No, because alcohol is a big business, right? No, hey, we all know drunk driving is a problem. We all know that kids drinking alcohol and all that, that's a problem. We all know that alcohol leads to alcoholism, right? That's a problem. But no, fuck it. No, let's continue to, you know, purvey that it's cool to drink alcohol, have a drink in the shower in the morning, whatever those fucking stupid commercials are. No, I'm sorry, right? No one wants to touch that. Can you imagine though? Seriously? All right, so we're trying to ban high-end gaming computers. Okay, I get it. Really a lot of strain on the environment and everything, right? But what about the problems with alcohol? It's a drug. It's a hard drug, as far as I'm concerned, right? Really, it really just it fucks with people. All right, tobacco, cigarettes, and all that. That's been a fight forever. You know, we used to, you know, but no one ever wants to. No one. You'll never see any of these celebrities that no one has the balls or the courage. Right. I always got to be the fucking guy. I always got to be the guy. I know that makes me sound like really self-important or fucking whatever, and I'm not trying to sound that way, but it's true. There's hardly, I don't know of too many people that are going to come out and say this shit. And then, of course, I don't really watch. I don't really listen to any other podcasts or watch what's going on in the world. So maybe there are some other people. I know I'm not the only one. I'm not trying to sound like a fucking egomaniac or messiah complex or some shit. But I always feel like I always got to be the guy to say shit when everyone else isn't saying shit, right? You know, where everyone else is just, you know, I've been in these places throughout different jobs when I'll say something and people are like, hey, man, I'm glad you said that. I've had that happen to me a lot of times. I'm not trying to sound like I have an ego. I'm not an egomaniac, okay? Believe me, I'm in a fight with my ego all the time. But you'll never see anyone, right? Can you imagine? Like, we should ban cigarettes. Cigarettes shouldn't be sold in convenience stores. All right, and alcohol shouldn't be sold in supermarkets. The fucking supermarkets near me, you know, selling alcohol. The fuck is that? All right, that shouldn't be a thing. Alcohol should not, I'm sorry, but this stuff is unhealthy for people. But no one wants to stand up, right? No celebrities, no, don't touch that because, oh, no. That will divide your fan base. You'll start losing money. It's controversial. Oh, no, let's just take the, let's not touch that. No, you don't have the courage. They don't have the courage. Weak people. People that just want to make money. That's what we talk about when we talk about the fakes and the phonies. All these people, they just want to make their money, don't want to stand up for what's right, don't want to, you know, it's real easy to make, oh, I'm going to donate to a charity. I'm such a good person. The fuck were you before you were making all your money? Right? Now, you were just focused on yourself the whole entire time, all throughout your career, and now that you're making all the money, oh, now you're going to help people. Now, you weren't helping people before when you're all concerned about yourself and your fucking career, right? So, I'm sorry. I wasn't planning on doing all this, but, you know, this whole, all this ban stuff, you know, banning, what are you going to do, right? So, if we're going to try to show ourselves, I'm trying to make a point here. My whole point is, honestly, I have no problem with people drinking alcohol. Ideally, in a perfect world, I don't think there should be cigarettes and tobacco and hard drugs and vaping. Cannabis is a natural occurring plant. I think that's okay to be used in some way, moderately. We shouldn't smoke anything. Nothing should be brought into our lungs, right? Besides oxygen. Maybe alcohol moderately, like one drink a month. You have that little drink. But I don't think at all, honestly. So, right? But now I guess, you know, now, and I used to drink alcohol, right? So I'm not like some dude that's been, you know, I'm not like ranting crazy like a madman, like some a hypocrite who's never drank alcohol and wants to get rid of alcohol. I've been there. I know what it's like. You get sick, fucks with your head, all right? All that issues. Fortunately, I've been, you know, I've never had, alcoholism or affected by alcoholism. I was a moderate drinker and I was able to stop. Fortunately, I have whatever it is in my system that I can, you know, stop. I was able to stop and go cold turkey. A lot of people don't have that for whatever reason. And they're fucking smoking multiple packs a day. Nobody gives a shit about them, right? Nope. We're just constant fucking money making machine right there. So, I'm sorry. I didn't want to come here and rant like this. None of this was planned, but how can you, this is the thing. How can you just like ban high-end gaming computers? How can you put on this whole big display of trying to be, you know, we're going to take care of the environment, but then people are getting fucked over by, you know, alcohol and tobacco and gambling. Now, sports gambling is on, you know, is a big thing now. Have you seen the commercials for that? So that's, you know, and people get addicted to that, right? But let's not, hands off, let's not talk about it. Let's just, you know, keep our heads buried. Let's, you know, that is the thing. And this is the stuff I try to avoid in the podcast. I'm not trying to make anybody upset. I'm not trying to talk about the shit that no one wants to hear. I get it, but I gotta do it. I gotta do it. I gotta talk about this shit. All right? That's, you know, I got nothing to lose. I got nothing to lose. Man, I don't mind. You know, I'm not here to vent on you or anything like that. I just gotta talk about, you know, how can you try to ban something? And I'm not trying to be like nut. I'm not trying to be some like crazy whack job renting to, you know, for, you know, you're trying to do a good thing. I get it with the environment. You're trying to ban the high-end gaming computers, the ton of wattage, all that. Understand that. But how do you pick that one thing? And then how do you like not say, well, alcohol? And then what about cigarettes? And then what about, vaping? We're not going to ban that, right? Hypocrisy, maybe a little. I don't know. You tell me. I'm just trying to make sense. I've been trying to make sense of the human race ever since my 30s. You know, I was a little kid. You know, I was like, wow, oh my God, everything's so great. Movies and video games and wow, look at everybody in the Olympics and awards. And wow, Metallica got a Grammy Award. Oh my God, so awesome. And then I grew up and I started to see the real world. And I hit my 30s and I learned about anarchism and I see all the shit that's going on. And I worked jobs and I got to see the inside of the workings of corporations and all that. And, you know, and I'm calling it as I see it. That's all I can do. I'm a human being. I never asked to be here. Here I am. And I'm just trying to, you know, I'm just trying to be as authentic. You know, does anybody know what that means anymore? Okay. I know there are plenty of people. I'm not the only one. There are plenty of people out there. Rant, you know, but I'm just trying to make sense. I'm trying to make sense of this whole human race thing. This, you know, what are you trying to do? You know, you're trying to, what, you know, is there a point? Is it just, I think it's a waste of time to try to make sense. It's just, you know, watching the human race, it's like, I don't want to say mental illness because I'm not trying to make fun of anybody that has severe mental illness, okay? But it is, it's like mental illness unleashed. And you look around the world. And that's all I can say. I'm not calling anybody an idiot. Okay. I'm not saying that if you have mental illness, you're an idiot or you're a problem. Please. Okay. I think you should understand what I'm trying to make. I don't need to fucking explain that. All right. My mental, poor people, people without the education, people that are preyed upon, people with, you know, all the people in the world that have it really hard. I fucking, you know, fucking bleed for those fucking people. Right. But just all this, yeah, I think you're getting what I'm getting at. I gotta stop this. So, but what do you, you know, but what about the consoles? 66% of the energy usage was by consoles. So we're banning 31% of the California 4.1 terawatts is by desktop personal computers. 31%, 66% by consoles. What are we doing? Are we gonna ban the consoles next? Oh no, can you imagine? Can you imagine? So, They're going to ban high-end gaming computers. Now, I don't know how many high-end gaming computers there are. Not everyone can afford those. Most people can afford consoles. $200-$300 once every 4 years, okay? I mean, that's the numbers. 66% of the California 4.1 terawatts used by consoles. Oh, no, you don't fucking going to ban those, are you? Can you imagine? Can you imagine California banning consoles? Right? I mean, 66%. What are you going to do, California? 66% energy usage by consoles. You're going to ban the consoles? Come on, step up the plate now. You already stepped up and swung that bat at the high-end gaming computers, and that's only 31%. So what are you going to do now with the 66% energy usage by consoles, huh? No? Come on, let's go. Put the, actions. You know, put the money where your mouth is and all that stuff. Can you imagine banning consoles in California? Holy shit. I would love to see that. I would fucking love to see that. I'm not saying that, you know, I would love to see people suffer and be without their consoles. I mean, a lot of people need their consoles and everything to escape. I mean, you know, that's the little piece of they work whatever or whatever's going on in their lives. And then that, hey, I use a console too. I'm talking about just, I would love to see it in terms of the reaction because that's such a ridiculous thing. But I'm just getting at, so, you know, what's next? We're starting to ban the Heineken. What's next? It's like the stuff I did in my videos with the banning the sugar. It's all coming to fruition. I was a prophet. Pretty soon it's going to be, they should ban sugar, right? If we're going to talk about trying to, you know, make the world a better place, right? So we're all focused on energy and the global warming. But what about people's lives? Seriously, it's always like the global warming, the weather, the energy consumption, blah, blah, blah. But where is it? But when it comes down to increasing minimum wage, it's always got to be a fight, right? No one wants to fucking do that. And when it comes down to like the cigarettes, all the ranting I was raving about with the cigarettes and the alcohol, no one wants to touch that. That's a moneymaker. Can you imagine how many people will be upset, right? But where do you go? Where do you start? You start in this whole ban thing. What about sugar? Sugar is in everything. I was at a supermarket last year or two. I go to the supermarket quite often. Mostly I go to a farmer's market. Me and my wife, we actually take turns. Cause our household is like a democracy. You know, I'm the man of the house, but I'm not like, well, no, you do this and I don't do, you know, no, we all take turns doing laundry. That's just fucking how it is, you know, equality, right? You know? So I went to the supermarket, but this one time I went to the supermarket, it was like a year or two ago. I was looking to get barbecue sauce and there was a guy there and he was just like, all these barbecue sauces, like sugar and everything. And I was like, I know. And that's the problem, sugar and everything and too much sugar in some things. Now it's not too bad. I was kind of talking about this earlier with, you know, evolution and why, you know, diabetes is still a thing and blah, 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 whatever. Now in most cases, right, I'm 50. I haven't had, you know, diabetes yet. And I've had sugar all throughout my life. Growing up as a kid, sugary cereal in the morning, go to school, sugary the soda in the can with my little fucking ham and cheese lunch, and then whatever, my little snack of Doritos, whatever. Come home, probably have more iced tea. At night, maybe iced tea with dinner or fucking chocolate milk. I don't think I ever had much water to drink. Like the way we raise our son, we don't have soda in the house ever. Sometimes we have lemonade or iced tea on occasion. When we go out, you know, to a restaurant, whatever, sometimes our son will get a sweet tea or whatever, or if we have a fast food meal, right? But he is, one good thing that I'm thankful for is that he's really good with drinking his water. So that, and eating his vegetables. So fucking, you know, thank God I kind of did one thing right. You know, with as far as passing down some genetics, you know, I don't want to get into the whole thing about, oh, I'm such a good dad and I'm my son and blah, blah, blah. But I'm just, you know, trying to, you know, be as authentic as possible. So sugar though, you know what I mean? So, I mean, I didn't, back in the 70s or 80s, you know, health conscious, but what? That wasn't the thing. So there was no drinking water. You went to, you know, if you're at school, you go out into the hallway, maybe get some water from the fountain, right? But it just wasn't a thing. No one ever, you know, diabetes, sugar, whatever. Hey, drink soda. Okay, we didn't. You don't feel any effects. It's kind of like drinking, you know, it's kind of like smoking tobacco and drinking alcohol. That's just how we are. It doesn't affect us right away, whatever. You got a hard life, you got a hard time. You're dealing with some things mentally, physically, whatever, and you don't really give a shit about your life. And so there's a lot of people like that. And so they just fucking want to just drink and smoke and they don't care about themselves too much. So there's a lot of people like that, you know, and my heart, you know, goes out for those people. I wish you could do something about, you know, and this society in a large part has failed those people or their parents or whatever, you know. I don't want to get too much in that. That can get personal for some folks. I don't want to trigger anybody, but you know, I can't skirt around it. I was trying to skirt around it a little bit, but I still got a touch on it. But I mean, sugar. I mean, and I passed a kidney stone. I passed a kidney stone, which was mostly a lot of calcium. And I drank a ton of milk. Ton of milk. And why did we drink milk? Why? Because the dairy industry and the government, the dairy industry, big money maker. I know this all sounds like conspiracy theory, nut job, paranoia talk. But no, it's a fact. The dairy industry was huge. And of course, they're going to have commercials. Drink milk, you know, calcium, blah, blah, blah. But why do they want you to drink milk? To support the dairy industry, to the farmers, to make money, right? So, come on, right? Hey, look, I'm just, you know, calling it as I see it. And that's a fact, right? No one's, we're not fucking cows, right? We shouldn't be drinking milk from cows as like three times a day. That's cow milk is cow breast milk is meant for young calves. That's it. All right. But of course, you know, it tastes good. You filter it and everything. And let's put some grains and sugary chocolate cocoa pebbles in there and put it in that bowl of, you know, cow breast milk. And that shit's good. All the chocolate of the cocoa pebbles gets, now you got chocolate milk too. You eat the cereal, you got that chocolatey, crunchy cereal. Then when you're done, you just drink down that chocolate milk. And I had that last night, actually, believe it or not. So, all right. I think I'm done. I honestly was just coming here to talk about, you know, a little bit about population growth, a little bit about the high-end gaming computers, and I thought this podcast would be just in half an hour, but you know, my ranting a little bit, but that's just how it is. Okay, so you know, and I'm sure, you know, hopefully. You're someone that, you know, is like-minded with me, and you might not agree with things, but I am this human being never asked to be born here. The people that birthed me, you can blame them, okay? You can blame them for fornicating and producing me, okay? So I'm here, and I'm trying to make the best of what I can do to live as happy a life just like anybody else, trying to do my best to, you know, get through this life unscathed from day to day and try to be happy. And at the same time, you know, do what I can. I'm doing this thing that apparently this is where the universe, you know, wants me to do this. You know, I don't know. Am I really? Is this podcast and what I do on YouTube really, really a conscious decision? You know, what are all the unconscious? You want to get a little philosophical? Now, what are all the unconscious things going on that actually drive me here to do this? Like, how much am I, like, what is consciousness? What is really driving me to do this, all this stuff? I always think about that. Do you ever think about that stuff? All right. Okay, so once again, next week, movies. We're going to have it all talk about movies. Let me know what some of your favorite movies are. Give me a few of them. If you don't mind, I would appreciate it. And then I'll share some of my favorite movies. We'll do one of these lists where we grab some little lists here of some of the world, you know, popular movies and this or that. Maybe some movies that you forgot about. Maybe some movies you aren't even aware of. I'm losing my throat a little bit. I haven't had a drink now for about an hour or so. And so that's it. And I'd appreciate that. And we'll talk about that next episode. And there we go. And again, feel free. You ever have a question or a topic for the podcast or whatever, a response to this, I will, you know, maybe I should do a monthly mailbag where you write in via my website, ephemerarift.com/contact, and I take all your comments and questions and I kind of answer them or at least address them, you know, here once a month, you know. So maybe that's a thing. I don't know. So if there's something you want to write about, if you like that idea, and you want to contribute to that, if I get enough of those, you know, I'll do a monthly mailbag kind of thing. I'll kind of think about that. Maybe that's a kind of a new little thing to do here to add to the podcast. So, you know, you can go ahead. Maybe you go ahead and rant. You want to rant about something going on in the world? You know, do it in a way that's not hateful, you know, or anything like that. And you can do it in a way, whatever. And I will read it, keep it anonymous. And I'll just read it and maybe I'll respond to it. And, you know, and a way for let other people know how other people feel about things. I know there's Reddit and all that, so, you know, it's not like this is anything new, but for us, our little community, whatever we got going on here, you know, let each one another know. You know, that's kind of what I'm trying to do here a little bit, you know, is all of us here listening or watching, You know, little community here, somewhat, you could say, loosely. I know not really interacting with one another. There's no forum, and there's no a Discord, and mostly because I don't want the hassle of managing that and have to manage whatever. I mean, do you want that hassle? You know, I'm sure you ask anyone that manages a Discord, especially a really popular Discord, not saying that my Discord would be really popular, but because I have a high number of viewers on my channel, obviously there's going to be more than just five people hanging out in the Discord. There's probably, you know, hundreds of people coming in, randoms, whatever. So as much as ideally I would love to have a Discord, I can't have the hassle of, oh my God, no. Like, you know, can you just imagine what the community people have to deal with who run those popular forums for a gaming website or whatever. You see, or on Reddit, you see some of the trolls and some of the posts and stuff. You know, no one wants to moderate, you know, and ideally, in an ideal world, I would have no problem with a Discord where you folks can just interact. But I don't want the headache of having to moderate. I don't want to police people. Like, if you can't police yourself, I don't want to be bothered having to police you and having to fucking babysit. So, you know, and I don't want anyone else to moderate and have to do that either. So I'd rather just not have it. So, and it's not a big deal at the end of the day. You know what I mean? You know? So, all right. So there we go. All right. So if you could send in some of your favorite movies or whatever, if you're still interested and I haven't pissed you off with all that I said in this podcast, in this particular episode, that would be great. And maybe I'll probably just get like one person left listening after this, that all that nonsense rant, that crazy rant. Man, I wasn't planning on any of this though. You know, I just wanted to come here but this is what, you know, sometimes we do, you know, you just gotta be as real and raw as possible. Okay. And I'm sure you are the same way. You know, that it's just, that's what's most important. Being authentic. Being authentic is more important than anything, I think, in the world. Okay. All right. So that's going to do it. Thank you very much for tuning in. Appreciate it. Again, favorite movies, whatever. Let me know. Comments. Hit me up on my contact form on my website if you feel comfortable doing that way. I prefer that way. But either way, you know, you are free to do what you want, and I will compile them as best I can, and we'll talk about movies next episode. All right. So, again, thanks very much for tuning in. If you made it this far, take care of yourself. Wish you all my best as you travel down your own path in life, and, hope to speak to you in next episode and, or possibly see you in the next video on my channel if you watch there. Till then, take care and so long for now.